Coming up on Red Hawk News, we have a special edition of Word on the Street.
We recognize the winners of character counts for January.
And juniors, listen up for upcoming SAT and ACT registration dates.
Red Hawk News starts now.
Coming to you from Red Hawk Studios at the Atlantic County Institute of Technology, this is Red Hawk News.
Welcome to today's episode of Red Hawk News, the most trusted source for all things ACIT. I'm Grace Hernandez.
And I'm Ava Lewis. The HOSA Southern Regional Competition took place on Saturday, February 3rd. Everyone tried their best and had an amazing experience. Andrea and Layla have more.
On February 3rd, ACIT sent competitors from the Health Sciences and Dental Assisting programs to the HOSA Southern Regional Conference in Cumberland County Technical Education Center in Vineland, New Jersey.
ACIT has several members who placed, ranging from 2nd in CPR and First Aid to 8th in Dental Science and Job Seeking Skills.
Multiple competitors were honored with medals and now have the chance to compete in the state finals.
The following 8 students placed and were recognized during the event.
Krisha Patel and Sofia Puerta, 2nd place for CPR and First Aid.
Parth Verma, 4th place for medical spelling.
Ishita Bhakta, 5th place for the medical terminology.
Mubashir Shams, 5th place for extemporaneous writing.
Patrick Lafferty, 7th place for the cultural disparities and diversity.
Jules Chavez Ortiz, 8th place for dental science.
Maybelline Perez Morales, 8th place for job seeking skills.
Congratulations to everyone who worked hard at the HOSA competition.
Great job everyone who competed, and congratulations to the winners.
Attention seniors. If you are attending the senior trip, today is the last day you can turn in your deposit of $340 for the final payment. Also, don't forget that the medical release form is due to Ms. Shaughnessy by March 1st. If you do not get this form in, you cannot bring any medication on the trip. This includes over-the-counter medication.
February is Kindness Month. Throughout the month, the counseling department will be hosting activities and challenges involving acts of kindness for students and staff. Students can send kindness grams to teachers and staff from February 20th through the 23rd.
During the week of February 26th, all students will be challenged to complete 12 random acts of kindness. Winners from each grade level will receive a prize. Good luck during the contest, and please continue to show kindness around ACIT.
Juniors, don't forget to register for the SAT and ACT. The dates are coming up. For the March 9th SAT, the registration deadline is February 23rd. For the May 4th SAT, the registration deadline is April 19th. And for the June 1st SAT, the registration deadline is May 16th.
For the April 13th ACT, the registration deadline is March 8th. For the June 8th ACT, the registration deadline is May 3rd. And for the July 13th ACT, the registration deadline is June 7th. Students who are eligible to have the SAT and ACT fees waived must complete the form on your College Board account. If you need assistance, please contact your guidance counselor. We'll be right back after this quick break.
The Performing Arts Program, through special arrangement with Music Theater International, presents 9 to 5, which is based on the comedy film from 1980 and the Broadway show that hit the stage in 2009. Tickets for this year's musical are on sale now. The curtain will open on Thursday, February 29th at 7 p.m., with additional evening performances on March 1st and March 2nd. There will also be a matinee on Saturday, March 2nd at 2 p.m. Tickets can be purchased online. They are $12 for adults, $10 for students and senior citizens. There are additional fees for purchasing online, but you can reserve your favorite seat in advance. Tickets can also be purchased at the door. $15 for adults and $12 for students and senior citizens. Tickets can only be purchased in cash on the day of the event. Please scan the QR code or visit www.acitech.org and click the link to reserve your tickets.
ACIT's annual Career and Job Fair is on its way. The event will be held on February 22nd from 11 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. Students will get the chance to meet and talk with the representatives from local businesses to learn more about their options when joining the workforce. The fair is open to all grades. However, freshmen must sign up with their guidance counselor to attend. This is a great opportunity for members of every academy to dive into the career of their choice. Vendors hold on-the-spot interviews and even games with prizes to market their company, so bring copies of your resume. ACIT's Career Closet is also available for students who need business attire for college and professional interviews. Students can attend during lunch periods and additional periods if allowed by their teacher. Look out for the Career and Job Fair on Main Street on February 22nd.
ACIT students and staff, 2023 to 2024 yearbooks are on sale now. The current price is $90 and will be for the rest of the year. Yearbooks will be on sale until March 29th. Get one before they're sold out. Seniors, you are not guaranteed a yearbook. We will sell out. If you want a yearbook, you have to buy it. Scan the QR code to order your yearbook. You can also order your yearbook at www.jostens.com/2024yearbook.
With prom season approaching, Project Prom is back. This volunteer project is gathering lately worn prom dresses, jewelry, and shoes. These clothes and accessories will be distributed free of charge between March 11th and 13th for high school students who need them to help make the prom experience accessible and affordable for everyone. Project Prom is currently accepting donations until February 23rd at Berkshire Hathaway Home Services in the JCC of Atlanta County, both located in Marquette, along with Aesthetica Salon in Northfield. Stay tuned to Red Hawk Media for more details.
All right, welcome back to Red Hawk News. Our correspondent hit Main Street for a special edition of Word on the Street, where we asked Red Hawks to name different songs.
Hi, I'm Leon Gazzara. You might recognize me from Word on the Street. Well, this isn't Word on the Street. This is a new game. It's called Music on Main, and it's really simple. I have a playlist compiled of random songs from my fellow classmates, and I'm going to see if the people of ACIT can guess either the song title or the artist.
Call me on my cell phone by Drake. Hold on. How I Blew by Drake.
Keep our clothes on the floor, open up champagne. Something with home.
My home or my house?
My house.
I thought it was my house.
It's my house.
Welcome to my house. Yeah, welcome to my house.
I'm giving it to you guys. Florida.
Welcome to my house.
I don't know what it's called.
Can you name the artist?
I don't even know the artist.
Oh my god, no.
It's like one of the indier ones. Like, I want to say it's indier one, and it's going to be like...
I literally don't know.
It's like, it's something with an F, right? Does it have an F? Oh, I give up. I can't think of it. I'm going to be so mad when they say it.
It's Nobody Gets Me by SZA.
Oh, that's not what I thought it was.
I don't know. Cause I know the lyrics. Yeah, I know the lyrics.
Think.
Can you play that? Can you replay it?
Yeah.
I don't know, yo. I know it's by Bruno Mars and Cardi B.
You give up? Yeah, Finesse.
Hey, brother.
That's it. Anyone want to guess on the artist?
I have no clue.
Avicii? Avicii? So you do know.
I've heard it. I just didn't know the name.
Yeah. This song is good. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Oh, Rihanna? Yeah. Small. And I've been so caught up in my
job, didn't see what's going on, but now I know. Is that, oh my gosh,
I've heard of this. It's You Should Go Love Yourself or something?
No. Is it Ed Sheeran?
It is not.
Oh my gosh. Shawn Mendes?
No, closer. You're getting there.
I have no idea. Take a guess at a pop star.
No clue.
Alright, who was it?
You were pretty close with the title. It's Love Yourself, Justin Bieber.
Oh my god. Okay. How could we miss that?
Dude, I'm like trash, dude.
Alright, well, thank you guys for playing. You did great. Thank you.
On Tuesday, January 30th, members of ACIT's JORTC program participated in a special ceremony that honored their best. Amelie Pimentel was promoted, achieving the new rank of Cadet Lieutenant Colonel, while Junior Ashlyn Worker stood down as the previous one. Jolie Parrish was promoted to Cadet Major and Deputy Commander. The promotion brings new jobs and opportunities to the cadets. According to Cadet Parrish, this is a cadet-run academy that provides the chance for them to grow into their responsibilities and to prepare for wherever their career takes them in the future. Other cadets were promoted in class, achieving their own ranks. Cadet Pimentel mentioned some of the new tasks that include leading the class during daily activities and managing the social media accounts for the program. The new marking period brings opportunities for all the cadets to pursue their new jobs. All of the cadets had to work to earn their ranks by showing initiative, leadership, determination, and other valuable traits. Congratulations to all the hardworking cadets for their dedication and achievements. For Red Hawk News, I'm Layla Miller.
Red Hawk News wants to acknowledge the monthly winners of character counts for January. The word of the month for January was empathy. Each of these winners fits the mold. For 9th grade, Madison Cruz. For 10th grade, Arem Chavez de Dios. For 11th grade, Jacob Diaz. And for 12th grade, Natalie Trinidad Lopez.
Each month, students can nominate a peer for character counts. The winners from the senior class will be in the running to win a character counts scholarship at the end of the year. Each of the winners also receive a Wawa gift card. Congratulations from everyone at Red Hawk Media.
Thank you for joining us. Don't forget to follow Red Hawk Media on YouTube. Please like and subscribe to receive the latest news from ACIT.
Also, discover more about ACIT on our digital publication, The Pursuit. For the crew and staff of Red Hawk News, we'll see you next time. And remember,
pursue what you love.